most projects don't go exactly as planned, and treehouse building is no exception. In this video, we'll go over some of the more abstract lessons I learned along the way while building a treehouse. And although it's not as hands-on as the other videos, in many ways, it's the most important. I first mentioned the idea of a treehouse to my kids in passing over 5 years ago without giving it much thought. It was something I wanted to do, but I wasn't doing anything to actually make it happen. Fast forward to a few years later, when we're watching an old home movie, and I see my oldest son tell his soon-to-be-born baby brother that he looks forward to playing in the treehouse with him. I'd become that dad. The type that promotes an awesome idea to the kids and then gets their hopes up when he doesn't do anything to actually accomplish it. It was then and there that I knew I had to get serious about building a treehouse. Like most of my projects, I started doing a ton of research to figure out how I was going to build a treehouse. I pictured boards pinned to a tree, and I had a dollar figure in mind for what this project would cost. After discovering GLs, stainless steel bolts, and deciding to build stairs instead of a ladder, we came in at 6 times that original estimate. It was then that we knew we needed to take a step back and figure out how we were going to pay for all of this. After all, the last thing we wanted was for the treehouse to be a financial burden for our family. If you've looked at the cost of GLs and their associated brackets and were turned off, let me suggest you do what we did. We decided that each person in the family was going to get a bolt or a bracket for their birthday until we had acquired all the necessary hardware.
Bobby! Bobby! Bobby!
What do you got?
Bobby!
Bolted!
Yeah!
Is that heavy?
Say treehouse! Is that a bolt for a treehouse?
Yeah, boom! Yeah.
Big enough, it'll be like muscles!
Yeah!
The kids got really excited about seeing the hardware come together over the course of a couple of years. We all learned a lesson in patience and what it's like to save up for something versus going in debt. And best of all, now the treehouse isn't a sore subject, but instead it's a source of joy. We also had to learn how to push pause on a project. When we decided we were going to build stairs, we waited for 3 months. The kids finally had their treehouse, and they had no way to get in it. During that time, I learned how to cut stair stringers, how to build stairs, and we also had to wait for the finances to be in order. After all, stairs aren't cheap. Be willing to push pause during the planning and building stages of your project. You don't want to rush something and have to live with the less desirable consequences for years to come. Although it may seem like overkill, I highly recommend you have an arborist inspect your build site. We had a free analysis done by a large nationwide arborist company. They pointed out how the trees I planned to build in suffered from co-dominance and would eventually split and cause huge problems. Also, recent land clearing had caused major root damage and soil compaction. The second site had much healthier trees with beautiful root flare and a natural forest floor. These trees are much better hosts for our treehouse. This next tip is one you're probably already aware of or you wouldn't be watching this video. There are some great tutorials on YouTube that can teach you how to do almost anything. Prior to building this treehouse, I didn't have any real construction experience. I'd never cut angles on rafters, calculated and cut stair stringers, or attached deck posts to a deck. I'll put the links to my favorite videos on these topics in the description. Something that's easily overlooked is building codes. Be sure to check the building and zoning restrictions in your area before you begin your treehouse project. Not following these restrictions can cause a lot of heartache. In our state, there's an exception in the building code for treehouses. As long as the treehouse is solely supported by the trees, there's no need for a building or zoning permit. All the more reason to invest in GLs so your structure doesn't have to be supported by posts. Also, depending on where you live, you may want to notify your neighbors of your treehouse project. Building something that obstructs their view or makes them think you can easily see into their backyard could be a source of conflict. Discussing these matters beforehand could eliminate a lot of headache. Once all your planning is complete and you get a build scheduled, I suggest you make it a party. Having a bunch of friends over for a treehouse raising is my idea of fun. And with all the work and heavy lifting required, having some extra backs around is a great idea. I certainly wouldn't have finished this treehouse anywhere close to the amount of time it took had it not been for the help of several close friends and family. And although it'll take a little more time, try to include the kids when you can and when it's safe to do so. Allowing them to put in some screws along the way will create memories that last a lifetime. Thanks for coming on our treehouse adventure to build a treehouse that's safe for your family and the trees. And although this completes this treehouse project, I'm sure there'll be future videos of zip lines and fireman poles and more additions to the treehouse. If you have any questions I didn't cover, feel free to leave those in the comments. If you've enjoyed this video series, give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing if you haven't done so already. And now that the treehouse is over, I won't be needing this anymore. on to the next adventure.